Well, thank you so much. Gosh, it's wonderful that you're all here. We've been told this has been sold out for quite a few weeks, I think. And how lucky is that? Thank you so much for leaving the television and coming to see something live. So it's great. I hope you'll enjoy our lovely young singers. We've had the most extraordinary competition in Herzenbosch. Of course, a wonderful town. We're thoroughly enjoying that bit too, is the little that they give us time off. There's not much of that. We've been chained to the table, judging for hours and hours and hours. And these poor young people, along with Hans, whose brain is just muddled by all the notes he's managed to play. But it's been very exciting, and we've got some just wonderful young people coming through. These ones didn't quite make it to the next stage, but they're good. So we'll start. Here we go. Now we're going to start with our... Oh, who are we starting with today?
Ibrahim.
Who is it?
Ibrahim.
Oh, Ibrahim. Oh, yes, Ibrahim, it's you. You're from Turkey, that's why I forgot. Yep. Now, come on, tell them your name, where you're from, and what your name's about and everything, please.
Hello, good evening. My name is Ibrahim Yeşilay. I'm from Turkey, and I'm 27 years old, and I'm going to sing one Turkish song. Name is Keops Arya. Actually, it's one from one oratorio. So,
I'm afraid what's going to happen. Yeah, straight in there. I've been watching him for some time. Excuse me. So we're going to leave you there, because that's his song that he sang last night, which I think is wonderful. And it's a very Turkish sound, but I want you to sing now your aria, please. And we're going to go back over something. So, Anels?
I'm going to sing now Una Furtiva Lagrima. From Elisir d'Amore, Donizetti.
It was that way. So. Yeah, I think it was this way, yeah. Come and find it now.
Yeah.
No, you lost it. we had it before. It's after that one, isn't it? Yeah. It's a difficult one. Okay. We're just going to shorten the introduction. Yeah. We'll just shorten the introduction, okay? Yeah.
Oh,
del suo bel cor sentì. I miei sospir confondere per poco a suoi sospiri.
We're going to go back to the Turkish mm-hmm. song. We're going to sing it just like that. Uh-huh. You know how you just finished this now?
Yeah.
I want you to sing the Turkish song, just like that. Why am I saying that?
You mean, I think more softly.
Yeah, because I think we're pushing a little.
Yeah.
A wee bit. Yeah. Okay, let's go back to the Turkish song. I want that. There's no need for you to use up all that voice. And also what happens, the sweetest sound to your voice, which is behind the voice that you're pushing out. Do you feel if I said the right thing there?
Yeah.
So let's go back to Turkish.
Yeah.
We're going to start at the beginning of it, but just like you did the Una Furtiva, the second time round, see if the Turkish, but you know, you have to express yourself, of course.
Yeah.
But, you know, just sing it a little bit lighter and see what happens with your voice there. Play it down a bit too. You don't have to push. You never have to push that voice. It's a lovely voice. Then why are you doing it? There's an answer.
Yes.
Because you're a tenor. That's what you have to say that when somebody, why are you pushing like that?
I'm tenor.
Exactly. So now let's change the thing. So do you want to sing the Turkish song a little bit longer? Let's start it again. But do it just like that. It's more expressive. And also with all, you want a tissue?
Just so much sweating.
Okay.
Yeah.
Tissue. So we'll have one in a minute. But go back on the song, the Turkish song, and just sing it very lightly, because there's absolutely no reason for you to push out your voice like that, because it doesn't work. The most important thing is for the audience to see that you're inside the song and you're not sort of letting it go. And then they need to come into your world. We're giving out a world, but then they need to come in and discover what you're doing and hear what you're doing. They think, well, that's really nice. And then you've just done it again, and you've expressed it rather than going at it too heavily. And they think, oof, that's not so comfortable. We want to feel comfortable when you're singing. It's incredibly natural what we do. It's not really, they don't need to know that. But it's not really natural, because it's very, very difficult. But they don't need to know that, because we're pulling the wool over their eyes and of convincing them that what we're doing is absolutely extraordinary and we do it all the time. Is that right? Yeah, that's right. Yeah. Okay, here we go. We'll get you a tissue in a minute. Oh, you are an angel. Thank you so much. You see, there's plenty of them. Sweat a lot.
thank you.
We'll have just dab it.
That's it.
No. Look, we've got three.
I wasn't crying.
No. She might want it back. Here we go.
Yeah.
Nice and easy. Impress us. Come on.
Thank you.
just like that, just like that. You ready to do it? Don't push. Do not push. Just sing it just as loose as you can. You've got to think that Una Furtiva is a folk song. Just sing it like a folk song. Everything's a folk song. Everything comes out of song. Arias just get bigger and bigger. But songs and folk songs and lovely stories. So you're telling a story, or this is a different sort of story, but just be very sweet and lovely, and we have to fall in love with you, which is quite easy. But make it happen. You have to make it happen. So the audience absolutely loves it. Not a single sound goes out of your mouth that isn't feeling comfortable. Do you feel this aria is comfortable for you? It seems comfortable.
Yeah, it is comfortable.
Yeah, okay. Well, then sing it comfortably. Very light. There's no pushing, okay?
Yeah.
I'll chop your fingers off if you push. Easy. It's glorious, but when you get to this, you're just about to do a cadenza.
Yeah.
Now, the most important thing when you're about to do a cadenza, you need to be relaxed, right?
Yeah.
So already you're already up there.
Yeah.
So what you need to do is when you do a quiedo, see, what you need to do is release all the air that's in you and rebreathe. What happens is most singers, they get to that stage and they're already up there and the breath is tight and there's nowhere else to go, but they forget to go release. And that's the most important thing for all of you. So let's go back over a couple of bars,
and then
you go into the gens. But do me a favor, just release all the tension out of you just before you go into the cadenza. So debreathe, and then rebreathe, and then go into the cadenza. That's the most important thing that in anything that you do, is take the tension out of what you've already been doing. I'm sure you get that. I can feel it.
Yeah.
It's there all the time, isn't it? Yeah. So the idea is that no one tells you to get to release the tension. And with a tenor voice, there is a lot of it there because you're having to do.
Yeah, sometimes I realize that I'm like
too high.
Sometimes I try to be more.
And you know what? It's called breathing out.
Yeah.
The most. What goes in's got to come out. And I always suggest we get rid of a lot of air from time to time. But that's the big thing with a tenor. It's with most voices, the tension in at sopranos too, they say, well, I can't get quite to the end. I said, well, I can tell exactly when you've started to become tense. It's about a page and a half before the final few notes that you actually need, those top notes, and then suddenly you're way up here and you can't do it. And you're too fearful to go. It's not much of an effort, but it can be part of what you do. And it just sort of looks like an effect. So it's something you just sort of breathe out. So let's go back just a few bars. Just sing those notes, you know. But that's wonderful. I mean, you sing it, Peter. But if we've got time, we can go back over it. If we've got time, but we can do either Il mio tesoro or go back over this one. Would you like? Sorry.
However you wish.
Well, do you want to just do this one again? But once again, when I'm doing that, you need to taper off these phrases. You don't need to push into the end of the phrase. You need to relax into the end of the phrase. Don't keep pushing at it. Because it doesn't sound that you're in control, really. You need to be in control just about everything you do. Everything that comes out of your throat, out of your mouth, you need to know that it's what you want, not that it's taking over your life. Let's just do you mind doing the last little cadenza? Let's go that, please, Hans. Thank you. Yeah, the same spot, yes. Now remember, just release, just do not push anything.
Yeah. May I touch you?
Yeah, sure. But just always make sure that when you take that breath in, what comes up, and you always relax, and you'll feel an awful lot better. And don't let anybody tell you any different, because it's all about you. You've got to relax. And being a tenor, there's more tension than anything. Okay. Time later on, we might sort of attempt something else. That's lovely. Now we're going to have Adriana. Adriana, come and tell us who you are and where you're from.
Good evening. My name is Adriana de León. I'm from Guatemala.
Guatemala. Yeah.
Guatemala. And I'm 28 years old. I'm going to sing Signore Ascolta. Do you have a national anthem? Yeah.
Do you have a Guatemalan in Guatemalan?
Yeah.
Sing it for me, please.
Thanks, God, she didn't ask me.
interesting. The mother tongue of each of us causes us to do some very strange things. Now, her own language, she's able to sing E-R-E-R, but you can't do it in Italian. Now, come on. Signore ascolta. It's so we need for you to make this so you can do it in your own language. So let's go back to the Italian and let's do it in the Italian. Because I'm not quite sure why you have changed the sounds and you have the sounds in your own language. Do you understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Okay. Here we go. Now, very carefully, because I'm going to listen to every single word now. So, you can do it. You can. The E's and the R's, it's a little bit the O. The O is not quite good enough, but you have all the other sounds. So, I'm not sure why you're doing this. So, okay. Do it. Come on. Okay. We try it. That's right. Pew. No. Si. Yeah. Didn't someone tell you that it's singing some strange Italian? But listen, it's different. That's how you were supposed to sound. I'm not quite sure why you did that, because it would have made all the difference in the competition.
Yeah.
Do you see? So you just need to get the right, this is it, you need to get the right advice telling you why did you make those sounds in the Italian language when you can perfectly do it in your own language. It's, why is that? Was it safety, safety for vocal?
Maybe because I always think I have to be an opera singer and I have to sound like...
You have to sound like you, just like you, gorgeous you.
Okay.
Come, should we get started? And I'm going to leave you to it now because I think you can do it. Come.
Okay.
Leave it top. Thanks. It sounds like, yeah. Start moving it around. Start moving it around. You're making all sorts of fun. It's very simple. Regge più. That's all you've got to do. Yeah. Of the tuo,
okay.
Tuo, just make it simple, don't overwork the lips.
Okay.
Thank you.
See, it makes all the difference. You don't have to do much. You hardly have to do anything. You just have to be told where to correct the things. It's so important that, you know, you sing like this and no one tells you, and someone just comes and says, just correct the words, and it sounds lovely. It really does. So can we move to the next song? That's very good. Very good. Good girl. Is this enough? In this one, when you're singing it, make sure you come in at the right place, in time, but keep moving in this aria song. It tends to go a little bit stagnant, sort of it stops too much. So just make sure you're always ready for the next entrance and you're moving through it. Doesn't mean that you're going too slow, just keep moving, and then I'll move the accompaniment. You'll hear it move along a little bit, okay? There we go. This is Tote Stadt.
Thank you.
sometimes the young people, they don't know that they can actually move things on even if it's not written like that. But it's so important. This aria is lovely, but it needs life in it. It needs to be moved, and it needs to have the brilliance of top notes going up and over and flowing. So it always sounds wonderful as you're approaching each phrase. It never gets like it's sort of getting... like it died. You don't want to murder the song, you want to keep it alive. Yeah. So the most important thing is that. That's good, we're going to leave that one. We'll move on to our next singer, if you wouldn't mind, thank you.
Okay,
thank you.
Hello, 我今晚演唱的曲目是麦克白的《尊敬爱的荣光》，是威尔第作曲，第二首是《死亡之城》，谢谢大家。So,
ladies and gentlemen, his name is Gao Renfeng, and he comes from China, 20 years old. Tonight he will perform one aria from Verdi, Macbeth.
So this is 20 years of age. This is amazing. And the young singers coming out of China today are really quite amazing. They're so well trained. They need training in some sort of other areas, but they are amazing singers. And we've had some very good ones, especially here in Herzenbosch. Not all of them got through, but my goodness, they're going to get there. They're going to take over very soon. But this is it. We better make sure not too much, but we need us to come through as well. Don't forget the Maoris. Oh. Sounded like the All Blacks, but nowhere in the musical world right now. Okay, here we go.
Perfidi arrangro contro me unite, levatense per sagam profetato, esse voi sanguinario feroce, ne son nato di donati noce. Temo di voi, veder fanciullo che vi conduce. No, ferma so trono, questo sarto ormite, o senz'armi per sempre.
Thank you.
tua sarà.
But he shouldn't be singing it. You know that, don't you?
Yeah.
Yeah. No, he's just too young. He'd never get the part. That's the problem. He'd never get the job. Because the thing is, he could never get through the whole opera. But one day he will. And that's the nice thing. I'd say about 10 years. But in the meantime, I've said... I know, don't be disappointed. You'll get there. But all these young people are in such a hurry. But I've said that the better thing for him to do now, because he loves singing and he's very intelligent, very musical, that the best thing for him to do now is to do song and every amount of church music you can do, gradually going into the, say, smaller operas, smaller arias. And so this voice will grow. And I would say in a few years, it's going to be tremendous. But not in this aria for the moment, please. Will you promise me that? You promise? But do you keep your word? Are you sure? I'm going to come and see you. And where is he from? Shanghai?
Beijing.
I'm going to come and see him. I'll catch up with him. I'll come and see you. And if you're being good and singing songs and beautiful art songs and Schubert, Schumann, all those things, is Tosti, some beautiful Tosti arias that would suit you. So should we sing? Let's go for the next song, shall we? Yeah. Oh, yeah. All right. Did you have enough? Is there enough water there? Yeah. Okay. All right. Let's do it.
So the next piece he's going to sing is...
Are you happy to do it in the key, his key? I don't want to test you too much.
Transcrição e
Just a while ago, and which he says it's a little bit high for him. Is that right? A little bit high. Yeah, a little bit high. So it's not a bad aria for him to sing. There's nothing wrong with him singing this, I feel. It's not going to hurt, but it is a little high. It's a little uncomfortable. So I've stressed on Hans to be brave. Okay, not too much. Don't go too fast. So you might be able to just sing a little bit of a cappella, but we're just going to take it down a bit. Okay, so we're going down. Here we go. Just a couple of notes of whatever you can do. Well, whatever's comfortable. He's looking at a lot of notes, and he has to play all those in the next key down or two keys down. That takes a lot of brain power. I could never do it. So I rely on you.
we can go two down.
Two down. Here we go. But you might have to sing a little bit of it unaccompanied because this is just new. But just to see how it goes. Yeah. He could sing this along, obviously two keys down is too much, isn't it? So one tone down wouldn't hurt to do it just until you get used to that height up there. Yeah? Do you want to try a little bit? This is really stretching friendship, I tell you. Try it again. Good top notes there. He has got them. It's not as if it's difficult, but for him to just feel how they go up there rather than sing the original, and then he'll eventually get to the original key. But once again, quiet would be better. Quiet would be better. Because the skill of this aria is to sing it beautifully quiet. Did you see that on the? It's written like that, isn't it? Oh, good boy. They only see one thing, it's loud. But never mind. Tenors, baritones, loud. No, there's something about the young people today that they're loud is great, and I think, oh no, there's not going to be very much voice left in a couple of years. So the most important thing is that they learn to sing within themselves, but also when we get to the climax, we've got the beauty of the voice going to the climax rather than the beauty of the voice having been burned out before the climax, and the audience is going, oh no, he's just missed the best bit. So we have to make sure that they come into and through the written, the music here, there's a roadmap, there's a speed, there's a dynamic, there's all the different things that you can find in the music. And if you go by those markings, you've got the interpretation of what the composer wanted. And then you can stretch the rules a little bit, but not too much. And so the most important thing is they look at the music and go by the music. So I hope you will learn that when you go back to Beijing. But I think we will hear from this young man very, very, very much, don't you think? Yeah. I think so, yeah. Thank you. Thank you very much. Come along.
I come from Slovenia. I'm 26 years old, and I will sing What a Curse for a Woman, Steal Me Sweetly by Menotti.
Oh.
Because you know what I'm feeling? This song, which it is dramatic, and I think you can come up in the dramatic part, but I would like it to go right down because the word thief doesn't come through, does it?
Yeah.
I can't hear thief.
Thief.
Yeah. It's got to be, it's a lot of th and lots of f.
Thief.
Yes.
Thief.
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 Yes.
Only
the English have invented that one. You know that. It's the most stupid sound.
Thief.
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 It's a.
Yeah. Thief.
Let's go.
Yeah.
Yeah, stupid. And I don't know why he puts that in, because the word comes around so many times, and I'm thinking, I cannot hear it. And it's, I think it's very difficult for, it's difficult for all of us. Thief.
Thief.
Mm. So let's go right back to the beginning, because it's I love the song, and I don't know if you like it, but I happen to love it. I like this sort of thing. It tells a story, tells a tale. Let's go right back down. Let's do as many markings down as we can until we get to the climaxes in the song. But when you are singing some of those climaxes, they really don't register with the words for me. So I think we'll have to try, and the top notes are fine. There's nothing wrong with those. But I think it's just some of those big stretches that just don't seem to work. And we really, really need to hear the story. Yeah, and the worst thing about it, we didn't get the story. That's the worst. And so it's your duty now to make us understand every single word. Please. So let's go down with the dynamic on the piano. You just try and sing it as ordinarily as you can, and let's see if that part of it works. You've got something like cast, but it's a curse.
Curse.
Do you know what a curse is?
Yeah,
yeah, good.
Yeah.
You are, I tell you, you are amazing. I went into the shop yesterday, and this young man, gorgeous young thing, started really going at me in Dutch. And it was when I said, English! Just like that, and it was so wonderful. I thought, gosh, I wish I had a brain like that. Immediately, the conversation went straight over to English. I thought, envy, envy, envy. So, I feel so useless. Anyway, it's wonderful that you catch everything. Thank you. Okay, so now don't push on anything. What a curse.
What a curse.
Yes, what a curse. Oh, hang on, you'll sound like me in a minute. You'll have this New Zealand accent, and it's getting worse. Worse and curse. It's a curse, yes.
What a curse for a woman is a timid man.
Really dislike him.
Timid man.
Do you know a timid man?
Yeah.
Yeah. Have you met one? Yeah, you know exactly what they're like. So your whole so just think of him, you know, timid man. humour. Okay. There's two thoughts. What a curse for a woman is a timid man. It's really, he's just a nobody, he's nothing. Okay. But somehow you love him, somehow. Okay, here we go. Just a straight sound here.
Okay.
That's
all
good.
Drawers
are wide open. Yes, that's good. That's fine. Sweet thief, for time's flight is stealing my youth.
Youth.
The TH, that stupid.
Youth.
Yes.
How can you do that without spitting?
What, spitting at everyone?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes. Just spit. Youth.
Youth.
Yes. Just make sure there's not too much moisture there, just that you don't spit. That's okay. So keep going. You're doing well. Doing well. So where you is? You know when the steal me. So make really enjoy that because it's a beautiful moment when it happens. So really wallow. If you're the first time, I ask a singer to wallow in that moment. Steal me. It's really quite sensuous because she's wanting something, isn't she? But it's not happening. They're bad. That's in Dutch. Steal me. No, do it again. Sing through it. Just I know it's just make sure that the sound is. Don't give up on the sound. Really enjoy what you're just about to do.
Oh.
I make it more softly, the kind of, especially the last one, or more.
But you have the soft.
Is it?
Do you feel
soft?
Do you have the soft?
Is it not too? I really open here.
You're talking about the last,
yeah.
Oh, steel, my yes.
Yeah.
So if you just, if you go back on, just go back on the phrasing. So steel my part, oh, and then if you're used to starting a note, are you able to start a note?
Sorry?
Yeah, you just sing the note up there, very, is it that one, isn't it? Yeah. Is that one? Oh, so is that one, she's going for the B flat, is she? Yeah. Yeah. Can you sing it just soft up there? It is high, isn't it? It's high. I think whatever you can do when you sing it, to do the phrase. Do the phrase before that. Steal my lips, steal my heart, steal my cheeks. Sort of when you release, yes. But the top note's hard to sing unless you have a finer voice, a thinner voice, but you don't. You've got that lovely big note, so you'll have to sing it like that. But the next note down, you could sing it softer.
Yeah.
Do it again? Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yes, please. Steal my lips, steal my heart. By seeing the top note and then you die off on the second note, which means you didn't have to push on the second note. The top note, I think you might achieve that very soft, but I don't think that's going to be part of your voice.
Maybe also because of the stir,
You've got an S, yes.
Yeah.
So if you had an N, you could start with an N up there. But can you do it with an N up there?
We can try.
Yes. So you have to sing the N on the top note, that high top note, mm-hmm. with an N, and then you can release the sound.
Okay.
So you'll have to go back.
Mm-hmm.
You'll go back.
Maybe it's shortly
before. Yeah, yeah.
Maybe die.
Yes, yep. So take it easy. You could do it a few times on the N and just see if that works for you. But remember that your voice is not that type of voice. It's going to easily, your voice is a bit bigger than that. So it's got a good, healthy top. So trying to sing it on a pianissimo is going to be, you need to sing another two notes up above that to be able to do that B flat. And sing them soft as well. So.
But I think also with that breathing,
Release.
Right.
He likes it. But the thing is, in the classes like this, which, I mean, I do days and days at my house with the students that I work with, but we talk about all this thing, but with a masterclass like this and so little time with each student, you want them to go with a small kernel of something that they need, because it's no use telling them all the different things that I can see, but if they go away with one that's a little bit of a technique or a trick that they can put into everyday phrasing and everyday musical life, because all these wonderful kids want to do is, all they want to do is sing, and that's gorgeous. I mean, you can imagine what the standard is like back at Herzenbosch if this is what we didn't put through. So, I mean, this is amazing. In Ariana's case, it was simply because she hadn't been told she's speaking the Italian language differently from what she really should. So it's not too much to correct, yet she now will go home and she'll make sure that whoever's teacher say, you make sure I'm doing it right, not doing it wrong for years and weeks and whatever it is. And like you know yourself, it's just little things, but you've got to know where your voice is. Your voice is a little bit bigger. It's not a great, large, rumbly voice. You've got a beautiful lyric soprano voice, and keep it like that. If it grows, well, then it grows. But that's, you have to wait for that. You're only young, so younger than me. Sorry, yes. Is that right? Thank you.
Thank you.
seen a pair of vocal cords? Have you ever seen them? Is it amazing what a pair of vocal cords can do without a microphone? So I think it's quite tremendous. Gorgeous. You have a gorgeous voice. I mean, can you imagine, as I said, the ones that didn't get through and the ones that got through. So what are we working with? We have a lot of wonderful singers in this world. Fantastic. Thank you, Dunning.
It was a pleasure to work with you.
That's kind.
That's a
prize. So the most important thing is that my duty as a retired singer now is to help the next generation through, because they are so hungry and they are so wonderful. You can't imagine the pleasure that we get just with these lovely young voices and the thrilling sounds that they make. So thank you very much, darling. I'm just going to put our Mr. Turkey back here. Come on. Are you warmed up? You've been sitting there for a little while. Are you all right?
Yeah.
Are you sure? It's still there. He wants to try a little bit of Il Mio Tesoro. Is that right?
Yeah.
Yes. He just wants to see where he is with that. Do you need any more tissues? We've got a supply. We've got a supply. Okay. So we won't do too much of it, Ibrahim, but we're just somewhere in there.
Yeah.
Do you want to do the runs? Many of the runs, do you, or something like that?
Oh, yeah.
We just start it in.
Yeah,
just, yes, go into it. Yes. Okay. Okay.
In your toro in tanto.
No. Il mio tesoro in tanto. We'll be floating on air. Stop being excited. Stop it, stop it, stop it. Okay, so we want it very, we need to feel very comfortable with this one.
Yep.
A long way to go. There's many pages, it's a long aria. Here we go.
Ditele che i suoi torti
too much.
che so che disgrazie morti.
Certainly sing, and if you could just control how much you sing it out, because you don't need more than that.
Yeah, that's the problem. When I sing a little louder than vibration,
yeah,
I cannot control that, and it's going like.
It's really good, but if you can just keep control of the volume of it, and also with elegant endings of your phrase, everything fades away with Mozart. It's always elegant.
That's
another little secret, that every time you do that, we will know that you're doing the Mozart that they're all wanting to listen to. But the aria suits you so well, but if you never push on it, you can sing it for the rest of your life. It's amazing. So thank you.